Hey now, I'm going to give you the official Trader's Landing Backtesting Spreadsheet for free and teach you how to use it. And all I ask is that you grab that subscribe button like this little one grabs mama. This is the Backtesting Spreadsheet. The link is in the description. I am not a professional spreadsheet programmer. I'm just a guy that knows a little about a lot of things. If you have any suggestions on how we can make this better, let me know in the comments. I'm more than happy to work with our community to make this even better. Now, this document was derived from my personal backtesting spreadsheet that I use on the channel and is very simple and straightforward. When you open up the file, the best practice is to make a copy of the sheet so you can always have your template to start from when testing a new system. You can do that by right-clicking on the Testing Template tab and clicking on Duplicate. This will create a copy of the template. Then you can rename the template so you can easily identify it. You can do this by right-clicking on the copied sheet and clicking on Rename. Let's call this one Test 1. So now that you have your blank spreadsheet up, the best practice is to fill out the first section. All the cells colored in blue is to be populated by you, and all the cells colored in green are auto-populated. The first thing to fill out is the system name. The second item is the pair you are testing, and I'm going to show you how to add additional pairs in a moment. The next thing is the time frame on the chart that you are testing. For example, you can put the 15-minute or the 4-hour, etc. After that is the minimum stop-loss pips. For example, sometimes when testing a system, I only take setups if the stop-loss for entry is greater than a certain amount. Like for Euro versus the US dollar, I would not take any setup that has less than a 5-pip stop-loss. I would also increase that for larger spread instruments, such as the Kiwi versus the CAD. The next cell is the date that you actually perform the test. After that, we have the start followed by the end dates. This specifies the date of when the test began and ended on your test. The eighth cell in this section auto-populates the time taken for the backtest by calculating the start and end dates. After that, we have the trading hours. I have previously shown tests where I take setups only during certain times of the day, or if you are testing only certain trading sessions. That information goes in this cell. The last cell of this section applies more to TradingView users. You can put your saved chart layout here so you can refer back to it if necessary. This is what it looks like filled out. The next section is test information. This worksheet has the ability to test a two-tier custom take profit system that you can specify here. The first cell is where you indicate how much of your total position you are entering with the first position, which is usually either one half expressed as 50% or the whole thing expressed as 100%, or you can specify custom amounts. The third cell is the initial capital for the equity curve. The cell after that is where you specify how much you are risking for your whole position, and finally is your gain on account based on the system performance in backtesting calculated with your initial capital. So if we were to fill this out, it would show this test will be using a two-tier take-profit system split between two different parts. The initial capital will be $1,000, of which we will be risking 1% per trade. So that will be 0.5% for each take-profit level. We didn't populate the test data yet, so the gain on account is empty. I will get to that in a moment. Next, we have the performance section. This section will show you all the entries that hit your stop, target 1, and target 2. It will also calculate the total amount of trades. You will have to manually enter how many wins and losses in a row because I do not know how to program that. If you do, please let me know in the comments. At the bottom, we have the calculation for the breakdown of your gains expressed as a percentage of target 1 and target 2 plus your total gain over the course of your back test. Below the performance section, we have the risk to reward block where you can specify the risk to reward ratios you are using for the back test broken down by target. So if you are targeting a 1-to-1 for target 1 and a variable for target 2, this is what it would look like. Below that, there are additional testing periods and instruments you can add. You can enter the pair name, the start and end dates, and you will make note of which numbers on the position list that this test occurred. For example, if you did 100 additional tests on the pound versus the yen between August 1st, 2010 and August 1st, 2011, which were setup numbers 100 through 175 on your position list, this is what it would look like. Now that our template is set up, we can start to enter data from our test. We start at entry 1, and for this example, we're going to simulate a two-target test where the first target will be 1-to-1 and the second target would have a dynamic stop loss. We are going to add when 1-to-1 is hit, our second position will move to break even. Our test start in cell B5, which corresponds to trade 1, first half of the position. When you click on the arrow, you will see a drop-down list of pre-populated numbers that correspond to the risk-to-reward ratio. It starts with negative 1, meaning that your position stopped out with a 1-to-1 loss, 0 is break even, 1 hit 1-to-1, 2 hit 2-to-1, and 3 hit 3-to-1, or you can just enter a custom number. This is what it would look like if your first setup hit target 1 and then went to break even. And this is what you would enter if your next setup just stopped out before hitting any targets. And now the next setup hits target 1 and then reaches the second target with a risk to reward ratio of 2.34. The easiest way to enter that when you are in the groove is just to use the drop down to enter 1 and then you can type in 2.34. So this is what it looks like fully populated with 100 trades. The worksheet can currently handle 1,000 individual tests. Now I'm going to show you the results of this test. There were 72 trades that hit target 1, 42 that hit target 2, and 28 that stopped out for a 72% win rate. Most wins in a row was 9, most losses in a row was 5. And the total gain on the account, taking all the trades, would have been 67%, risking 1% per trade. If we started with a $1,000 account balance, we would have made $692.75 over those 12 months. You can see here the equity curve balance expressed as real numbers in column L. And if you go to column M, you can see the equity curve graph. Is there anything else you want to see on here? Be sure to let me know and check out these systems that are excellent candidates to backtest. Bye for now.